Effective sales is about high service, never about high pressure. Let me give an example of one of the most effective low-key sales presentations I've ever seen in my life. For many years, I lived west of Colorado Springs up in a small town called Woodland Park, Colorado. And it took about a half an hour each day to drive out of the mountains. And as I drove out of the mountains each day, I would go past a little restaurant called the Hungry Bear Restaurant. And as I drove past that restaurant every morning, I would see a white Ford pickup out there with black lettering on there. And all it said was Joe the Concrete Guy and a phone number. So I'd see his truck there every day and I'd get kind of a chuckle. And then one day, about 2 years after I'm living there, I'm out in my driveway and I realize I need some steps poured at the end of my driveway. So naturally, I think about Joe the Concrete Guy. The next morning, I pull in the restaurant, I get his phone number off the truck, I call him up a couple of days later, and Joe comes out to my house. Now, when Joe pulls into the driveway, he is so down to earth, the basic cool mountain guy, right? He's got long bushy hair, a big beard, t-shirt, shorts, and flip-flops on, right? Nothing pretentious about this guy, nothing pushy, nothing slick or super sophisticated, right? So Joe gets out of his truck, and he comes down to the edge of the driveway, and I'm explaining to him where I want these steps poured. And every now and then I would look over at Joe, and he was looking at a motorcycle trailer that I had parked next to my driveway in the dirt and the rocks. And so finally I look at Joe and I said, Joe, is there something interesting about the trailer? He says to me, why is your motorcycle trailer parked in the dirt and the rocks? And I looked at him and I said, well, Joe, as you can plainly see, the driveway is not wide enough for the trailer. Joe looks back at me and says, you know, when I'm here pouring your steps, I could widen your driveway, right? Instantaneously, my budget goes from $1,000 to about $6,000. Now, was Joe high pressure? Was he some slick, you know, snake oil salesman? Of course not. Joe was all about high service. So we write the paperwork up, and at the end I said, Joe, I gotta tell you, that was a beautiful technique to get the average ticket up. He goes, what do you mean technique? And he goes, that was just common sense. I said, well, I know it's common sense, but it was a brilliant use of the technique. He looks at me and he says this, Mr. Long, what does it say on the side of my truck? And I look over at his truck and I said, well, it says Joe the Concrete Guy, right? He goes, yeah, it doesn't say Joe the Concrete Window Siding Roofing Guy. It says Joe the Concrete Guy. That's all I do. That's all I've ever done in my life. For 40 years, I've been pouring concrete in these mountains. And I learned a long time ago, the best way to serve my customers is that when I walk on a piece of property, I look for every problem that concrete can solve. You see, that's a professional approach to sales. You gotta look for every problem that your products and services can solve. That's how you sell like a professional, and that, my friend, is not high pressure, that's about high service.